Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We just saw Emerson College take down MIT, and we're moving on to our next matchup. It's going to be Cincinnati versus Dakota State.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we are here at the Tespa Collegiate Series. Our next match, like you said, Cincinnati versus Dakota State University. Kind of a Goliath versus David story here. Mm-hmm. The members of University of Cincinnati are nearly entirely master-ranked players with two diamonds, whereas Dakota State, not too shabby, but a lot of platinums and one diamond.
Okay, so yeah, these games will be taking place in our northern region here. And if we take a look at the standings, we do have some schools already with a 1-0 record. Purdue on there with Robert Morris. Robert Morris, they do have that esports program over there. One of the first colleges, actually, to provide esports scholarships for their players.
Right, so it's really cool to see them in these standings. Obviously, we've only had 1 week of regular season play, but hopefully, you know, RMU's program gives them the advantage and we see them later on.
Yeah, we've already seen over the course of the last 2 days that teams are well underway to that 3-0 record to secure a spot in the regional playoffs right now. It is going to be Cincinnati versus Dakota State. And once again, we are starting off on Lijiang, week number two. Mm-hmm. All the first maps are set. So Lijiang is going to be our first map, and then it's loser's choice from there. So right now, what are you expecting to see out of this match?
Well, for the University of Cincinnati, I want to see fireworks. We're going to be taking a look at their player roster. We've got Kevin, Rukata, GGG, Undead Donut, Biggie Nose, and Saber, respectively a math major, information technology, computer engineering, IT, cybersecurity, more IT networking, and another IT networking major. And Jamerson on this squad, Undead Donut, Grandmaster tier player.
I'm not even a Grandmaster yet. I mean, I'm only Masters, so a lot of grinding left for me to do.
Big deal.
It really is. It really is, because that not only puts you into Grandmaster, but you're high up there in the top 500.
Yeah,
top 500 starts around 37.
You're very comfortably in the top 500. And another player I want to highlight as well for University of Cincinnati is Biggie Nose. Has over 700 games. He has 80 hours of McCree play. So their DPS is going to be amazing.
So they might be the Kings of the North, but Dakota State are going to be challenging them here. We have Sir Twiggles, Cup Holder, Zeke, Fufu, Durthang, and Shromo, a Cyber Ops major, Production Animation, Computer Game Design, Computer Science, Production Animation, and Network Security.
You and I joked about this a little bit before, but Cyber Ops as a major is one of the most badass named majors I have ever heard of.
Yeah, it definitely does. I mean, it kind of harkens to like Ghost in the Shell, you know, like this futuristic world where
my name is Seamus Anderson, Cyber Ops.
You know, two people on one keyboard, you know, trying to fight all hackers.
No. That episode of NCIS never happened. Anyway, we're into the map.
Yeah, so we're starting off here on Lijiang Towers. I think this is going to be the night market portion. I saw just the stairs there and I was like, that's night market.
Nice.
Yeah. Take a look at that. Some pork ramen. Sounds delicious about now.
You're making me hungry now, Jamerson.
I mean, with a name like Undead Donut on the opposing side, that didn't get you like salivating just a little bit?
No.
And then we've got Empty Cup Holder. Empty Cup Holder right now.
Like my dreams, all of these promises of food, they're all empty.
We can, you know, rectify that. It's Southern California. We're here in Burbank. There's so much good food around.
Get some tacos later. Speaking of which, yeah, we are in Burbank.
Tacos.
I've heard a lot about SoCal tacos.
Oh, they're delicious. Just the street tacos.
You'll have to show me.
Yeah, find a food truck. They're everywhere.
All right, let's take a look at these comps. Dakota State University are running Mercy and Lucio. They have a Reinhardt 2 on King of the Hill on a control map, but no Onyx. Interesting.
Yeah, this Mercy play, she's so vulnerable in these team fights where it's so easy to get a flank in the, you know, Biggie Nose coming in with the left click. She gets the kill onto Mercy. That's what we were talking about. She's so vulnerable. She has to play behind that Reinhardt, but she got caught out. Undead Donut will clean up Sir Twiggle here. Reinhardt charge does come out, but Undead Donut finally answers back, and it's going to be University of Cincinnati taking this convincingly in this first team fight.
Folks, there's a reason why we highlighted the DPS players of Cincinnati. It's because they are two very high-ranked players, and we saw that with excellent aim. Finding the frag on the support early on just meant the rest of the team was able to win that fight pretty easily.
Yeah. Wow. Nice! Flicks coming out from Biggie Nose.
What, like a predictive headshot on a Tracer and then the flashbang gets the kill?
That was ridiculous. Kevin gets the kill onto Zeke and things are looking bad for Dakota State right now.
Onto Dona, close to his Death Blossom. Nearly every ultimate already available for University of Cincinnati, and a quarter of the map has passed. Romo trying to come in. Romo can make a play on this Tracer happen. He can destroy the supports of Cincinnati if he's able to tiptoe around the DPS first.
But let's talk about this Ana right now. There are three ultimates up before Ana's, and the Graviton Surge does come out. Undead Donut follows that up with the Death Blossom.
Wow.
And there's the emote coming out.
They're getting backcapped. All right.
They are, though. It's Shromo who was trying to, you know, stall it out for his team, but he's going to get easily cleaned up. He does pick up two kills off that, though.
That emote from GGG, a little bit preemptive, but I will say they're probably feeling very confident about their chance right now. Undead Donut gets taken down. Now it's a 5v6 in favor of Dakota State. They have a couple ultimates to work with. Earthshatter coming out. It's not going to hit anything. Gets shielded, and that is going to be University of Cincinnati coming back in this team fight.
Oh, but Rukata, as you say that, gets the flame strike, and now the nano boost comes out on the side of University of Cincinnati, and that Reinhardt doing so much work with the help of GGG. He's swinging on the members of Dakota State, picks up another kill, and take a look, the ulti back up for Rukata. He's got another Earth Shatter, but Dakota State University have three of their own.
Biggie Nose now is going to be poking back and forth with the members of Dakota State. Nice Earth Shatter.
Yeah, and he does get that follow-up kill onto Durthang. That's a 2-for-2 trade as actually Dakota State University swinging on back against Cincinnati. Now the Deadeye does get popped, and nice play coming out from that Reinhardt.
The point was taken, but there's only one or two remaining members of Dakota State here. And what was so funny on that kill from the McCree was that the Reinhardt hammer knocked the Zarya into the Deadeye.
Yep, so that's teamwork right there. Now the Reinhardt does charge in, but that's going to be an easy cleanup for GGG and Undead Donut. That's Dakota State falling here on the first point against University of Cincinnati.
These control maps have a best of five format, however, so for Dakota State University, if they can pick themselves up and come back, they have a few more rounds to play, and perhaps it's just that this game type not really in their favor, but it looks like we'll be onto the Garden as the second phase.
But did you see that first team fight there? I was trying to highlight how usually Ana is the first person on a team to get an ultimate.
Mm-hmm.
But her two tanks and one of her DPS had it way before her.
The first shots we saw in the game from Biggie Nose on McCree were literally 100% accuracy. He just, I think it was... What,
taking out that Mercy.
Four shots, yeah. And he picked up the Mercy easy. And that really shows practice pays off.
So now Dakota State University staying away from that Mercy as we are here on to the Garden portion of Lijiang Towers. And we haven't seen many teams actually colliding on one side of the map. Either one goes from the bridge side or the other goes approach from the White Room. And it's going to be Dakota actually approaching from the White Room. Biggie Nose getting some shots through that shield. He does land a dink.
Charge coming in from the Reinhardt. Nice shots from Biggie Nose, finding another one. Three kills over to University of Cincinnati. They're going to be able to clean this up so easily. And that's the kind of give him an inch, lose a mile sort of situation there. Part of the issue with going into the White Room is if your shield dies, you have nowhere to run back to.
Yeah, the retreat is very difficult there. And can we talk a moment about how quickly Rukata actually got his Earth Shatter there?
It was nuts.
Alright, so now Rukata finds the kill onto Durthang. Sir Twiggle falls to Kevin. Rukata doing so much work on this Reinhardt. Now it's just the easy cleanup coming out from Dakota State. Or excuse me, University of Cincinnati.
Yeah, University of Cincinnati are looking clean as Dakota State are being cleaned. 100% charge. Rukata has his Earth Shatter available, as well as a Ana Nano Boost. McCree, Deadeye, Reaper close to his ultimate. Pretty much everyone in Cincinnati is very close to their ultimate or have it already.
Yeah, Shromo did switch off to this Hanzo, but he's going to get cleaned up by Biggie Nose. And you know, when you give a McCree this much space, it's so easy for him to land his shots. The Deadeye not going to quite connect, but there we go. Nano Boost, it's been to win. Coming out from Undead Donut, he does have to fall back as the Earth Shatter does come out.
Transcendence answering the spin to win pretty well there, and as a result, it's a 5v5 situation. Fufu maybe going in, the Hanzo ultimate, Dragon Strike, not going to find anything so far. Reinhardt charging in, he's going to be left alone though.
Yeah, and there is 62% on the board. They have to make something happen very quickly, or they will be under a lot of pressure. Zeke finds the kill onto Saber, but Fufu gets cleaned up by GGG.
Crucially there, the Reinhardt shield was eventually taken down, but not taken out fast enough, and GGG picking up three. That probably stands for the amount of G's in his name. One lonely Lucio on the point, but Dirthang taken out. Dakota State now, they did back up again like we saw on the first map, but it's not really with conviction.
Yeah, these team fights going so heavily in favor of Cincinnati here that they have no problem cleaning up any stragglers that try to back cap here. So, I mean, 14% in the grand scheme of things, not too great if you're going to lose that team fight. And right now at 90%, wow. Cincinnati have to...
You could do that? Did you see that?
I did not.
The Graviton Surge coming through as of right now. So many ultimates in favor of University of Cincinnati. We're looking at the Rhino as he is boosted and angry. Another kill over to Cincinnati as the Transcendence coming out might delay the point for Dakota State. But he is the only remaining member of DSU, and he is DS Dunzo. That's gonna be University of Cincinnati taking the second point.
Yeah, and so University of Cincinnati with a very dominant lead so far against Dakota State. What do you do as Dakota State at this point?
You probably gracefully lose this next map, and then you go to a map that you're very comfortable on.
Okay. And so I would imagine at this point they would definitely want to avoid these King of the Hill maps.
Yes, I would. Unless on one of the other King of the Hill maps, you know, Ilios, they have something very, very cheesy planned. It's going to be hard for them just to match up pound for pound against the University of Cincinnati. And that's really what some of the issue has been here. Cincinnati's fraggers have just been finding kills a little bit quicker. And even though Dakota State have done some intelligent things, they've sneaked around, they backcapped twice now, it hasn't been able to sustain them through a match.
All right, and now we are moving on to the third point here, the command center. Dakota State University need to run this back and go for that reverse sweep against University of Cincinnati to get that first map, but Cincinnati currently holding a great lead against them.
Ooh, and coming around the side when Dakota State was prepping on the other side is going to be perfect. Onzo shots not connecting while this Reinhardt is all alone. Doesn't make it out, though.
Yeah, Biggie Nose is now on this Roadhog, and Rukata busting out that bash.
Wow.
Gets a double kill for himself. That's a triple for him. There we go. Biggie Nose finally getting a kill. Fufu will get that consolation kill, but it's not going to amount to much as the point is unlocked and Cincinnati take it first.
Cincinnati trying to style a little bit. That setup from Rukata was so smart. They had all those members walk through the middle and then set up that Bastion all the way around Dakota State and then just obliterated them with the Bastion damage while they did not expect the flank.
Yeah, Bastion does such a great job of just ripping through everything. So that Reinhardt shield isn't going to be lasting long for the team, especially when he has that Pocket Mercy with the damage boost. Does so much damage. That 2,000 HP shield just melts. Now we do have Biggie Nose actually getting dropped. Fufu will finish that off, but it's going to be Undead Donut on this Genji, getting a double kill off of that Dragon Blade. There's a third. There's a reset. And then Shimada yep. Brothers, it's going to be Genji coming up on top.
Shromo getting reflected by the Genji and Undead Donut finding the fourth kill in that mini spree. And we were highlighting Undead Donut as being a Grandmaster tier player before, but we haven't really seen too much of him. That's just because of all of University of Cincinnati have been showing off.
Yeah, and there's that Reinhardt shield just melting to the Bastion, damage boosted Bastion. We do have his ultimate coming out right now. Tank mode doing so much damage. That's just going to force the rest of Dakota State back. Now we do have the Nano Boost coming out
Graviton.
Along with the Graviton Surge. Sir Twiggles does get a kill onto Kevin, but is that going to be enough as the Transcendence is popped on the side of University of Cincinnati? Now it's going for a 3v2 trade, make that a 3v3. So Biggie Nose trying to survive here, but he gets melted down by that Zarya, and now Dakota State have a chance of taking this point.
Very nice combination play with the ultimates there. We see Rukata trying to run on Bastion, sets up again, coupled with a really nice right click jump, and then is able to kill the Bastion. The setup there with the Graviton in conjunction with the Reinhardt and then the Hanzo Dragon Strike was perfect. And as a result, Dakota State University, they win that team fight and they get the point.
Yeah, but this next team fight for University of Cincinnati, they can just bait out as many ultis as possible. They do have that Mercy Resurrection. And we also have the Dragon Blade coming out, and that's Undead Donut immediately getting the kill onto Dirthing, and they were caught so unaware there. He's already got a double. Saber picks up a double for himself. And another convincing team fight coming out for University of Cincinnati.
University of Cincinnati able to retake the point. They're at 80% right now, which means Dakota State University is going to be able to collect themselves a little bit and then come back to the point. But it's really their last chance now. Nice hook onto the Zarya.
Oh, wow. Her model was just barely peeking out through that Reinhardt shield. Biggie Nose doing a great job.
Oh.
Nice. Another hook coming out. He drops down to 14 HP, and now this Tracer's going to jump on top of him. Yeah, it really doesn't matter. Graviton Surge coming out, and that's just trying to stall them as long as possible, because there we go. Cincinnati will take Li Zhang 3-0.
Props to Dakota State University for coming back on that last map and getting to 37%, the farthest they did, and had a very strong team fight. But really, University of Cincinnati did so well. We are going to take a look at the play of the game from Rukata, and this is one of those earlier moments when you said his Earthshatter was up so quickly, and it did so much damage.
Yeah, this was before actually the point even unlocked.
Right.
So in the 20, 30 seconds where they had time to engage there, he had his ultimate, and he put it to great effect, and that kind of set the tempo for the rest of the game.
He was able to develop his ultimate that quickly, which means he did a ton of damage, and then use that ultimate, and they completely wiped Dakota State University. The amount of damage that Reinhardt must have done within that, like, 15, 20-second frame was incredible.
Yeah, we also have to talk about the Zarya on the side of Cincinnati University. Was doing a great job. We saw a lot of great, you know, Graviton Surges. The team play looking incredible. The solo play also looking incredible. Take a look at this right here. We are on the tower portion here. And the Graviton Surge comes out, and, you know, he has...
His name says it.
Yeah.
His name says it all. G-G-G.
I mean, that right click, you know, a lot of awareness, situational awareness coming out from him. He knew he didn't have to panic there, and just went for the right click and got the double kills so easy.
And finding that first frag onto McCreed, too, was awesome. I mean, it's University of Cincinnati. We're only into the first 2 weeks of the TCS, but they're looking incredibly strong. Gonna look at some more plays. And this was that earlier, the first map that we saw on Lidong Tower, where the fight started with a picked off support in favor of Cincinnati.
Yeah, this really did set the tempo for the rest of the match here. Just a dominant first win team fight off the back of the pick onto that Mercy. And that left a bad taste in their mouth. There we go. Another Graviton Surge coming out, followed up. They, you know, individually, they play well, and as a team, they're so coordinated. We saw these nano-boosted Reinhardts coming out, and Rukata was just like a bunker buster there, just getting in and just absolutely tearing it up against them. Biggie Nose didn't fare too well against that Tracer. Fufu was actually doing a good job.
Fufu and Tromo had some pretty good moments. They're the key players to look out for, I would say, for Dakota State University if they want to come back in this match. And for University of Cincinnati, in this next map, no matter where we're going to go, they want to tell all the other teams in the competition that they are not here to play. I mean, technically it's a game, but they're here to win, because they lost to the Longhorns before in the Tespa Summer Series. And my guess is, Jamerson, they don't want to see that happen again.
No, not at all. As we move on to King's Row, remember, this was Dakota's actual pick. So, University of Cincinnati starting off on the offense, Dakota starting off on the defense. Looking at the compositions, there's actually one real interesting pick coming out from Dakota State.
A defensive Hanzo.
Yeah, we normally see it on the offense,
right?
Not so much on the defense.
Well, technically Hanzo is considered a defense hero, but in terms of competitive play, you're absolutely right. We generally don't see him that often used defensively on King's Row, at least. They have Mei as well, so they can protect that choke point. And actually, theoretically, the Hanzo could put that Sonic Arrow in the top sort of window to see if they're going out that way. And take a look at this board. Shaman versus Paladin. Yeesh.
I'm not too well versed.
Yeah, wrong
in Hearthstone. Yeah. I'm sorry. I'm only here Wednesdays and Thursdays for Overwatch, Mondays and Tuesdays for Hearthstone.
Fair enough.
Yeah. But right now, Dakota State University need a great defense against Cincinnati here. They are down 0-1 against them. We'll see if this Mei pays off for them along with that Hanzo. The Mei wall comes out, but there is a hole in it that's going to allow Cincinnati to actually push in and take a look. Biggie Nose trying to get on top of that Hanzo. Dromo, is he going to be able to let the shots? No, but Biggie will, and that's going to be a nice exchange coming out for them. That's a double kill for Biggie. Dirt ain't going down. It's all down to Zeke.
Wow. Biggie missed a few of those earlier shots, but the accuracy following and the headshot accuracy was insane. The team able to walk over Dakota State's defense, and Biggie Nose is looking for something really, really cheeky.
Yeah, again, take a look at the ultimates on the side of University of Cincinnati. They farm it so quickly. Biggie has his as he does fall to Fufu. That was pretty aggressive of him.
Yeah, that was a little bit too aggressive. And he does get punished for it, but they have the forward spawn, so they can come back pretty quickly.
Yep, right now we do have two ultimates on the side of Cincinnati. We've got Undead Donut back on that Genji. He's got his Dragon Blade at the ready. There's a third one coming up as Rukata gets his Earth Shatter, and Biggie has had his Deadeye for a while now.
No combo available yet. Remember, Ana's ulti was increased. It takes about 20% longer now to charge it, so they can't nano boost the blade, but they have the Earth Shatter anyway.
Yeah, that's going to be Biggie coming in with a three-man Deadeye. Undead Donut starting to clean up here, playing a little Ninja Gaiden versus this Hanzo. And Stromo getting a double kill.
With help from Tracer, but that still counts.
So right now, Cincinnati making great headway here on the streets portions of King's Row. Stromo has to be careful. I mean, he's one shot away from death.
He is playing a dangerous game there. Stromo, calm down. Charge coming in. They're going to try and contest still, but a nano boosted Reinhardt and that Graviton.
Oh,
how did Biggie Nose get here? What?
I don't even know. I thought we were looking at Dakota State for a second. That kind of flank you generally don't see coming out of a McCree. But yeah, that golden gun, well earned.
Oh, yeah. I'm telling you, dude, this guy probably has like the highest amount of time played in the server in NA, or at least he's up there.
You said 700 games?
It's 700 games, 80 hours of McCree this season alone. Like,
I mean, you and I combined don't even have like 200
games, dude. That's a lot of games.
Yeah.
Oh man, nice stick. Unfortunately, not able to get through Roadhog's thick hide. They're trying to fight back.
Yeah, we do have that Dragon Strike coming out, and Stromo coming in, got the double kill. He has to wait out this barrier, but you know,
4v4.
Yeah, it is a 4v4 right now. There we go. Fufu will clean up Biggie Nose, but Saber finds the kill on the Sir Twiggle. There it is. Stromo trying his best to keep his team in this game.
Fufu now the last remaining member. Mercy and Lucio coming from the side. They're going to be spawning really close. The defensive spawn on most maps, specifically King's Row, is very close to the actual point. But if University of Cincinnati can just keep up this aggression, it's not going to matter that much.
Great whole hog coming out on the side of Cincinnati. There's that Earth Shatter. There's the follow-up. There's the res coming out from Dakota State. So they are right back into it. But Twiggle just getting respawned. He has to join his team right now. The Dragon Blade finds the two kills so far. Now he's going to go ahead and get the melee. It's actually the right click coming out from GGG on that Zarya. And that's going to be Cincinnati completing out King's Row with a time of 4:29 remaining.
Essentially, half the map time allotted was what it took them. 4:29 out of a 9-minute map. Yeah.
Yeah.
Very fast. The fastest time we've seen so far in the TCS.
It definitely was. Yeah. We saw one team finish it off with like two and then three. Yeah. Yeah. So convincing offense there coming out from Cincinnati. But it's going to be Dakota's opportunity to strike back against them.
And we'll see how they strike back. We saw the Genji before. We saw, the Hanzo from Stromo and Fufu's Tracer. I'm expecting probably at least the Tracer on this initial point, and whether or not Dakota State tries and runs this Hanzo as well. When you're this kind of a situation, generally, like, comfort picks are the fallback. It's the best option because you're always going to feel like you can do something on comfort picks. But actually, Stromo, instead of Hanzo, he's going to be going for Widowmaker, which still can enable a lot of early picks. And if they can find those picks, they can go pretty aggressive. He's deciding. Three tank would be pretty interesting too.
Yeah, so nope. Stromo might go for that Pharah. They have the Ana there. I see triple support coming out on Dakota State University, mm-hmm. So that might actually signal a that's a odd composition for a 3-2-1.
Well,
generally it's three tanks, two supports, and then a
DPS. As opposed to a this is like a 2-3-1.
Yes.
Either way, though, it's going to run into trouble. Double shotguns, as well as a mate for University of Cincinnati.
Yeah, so University of Cincinnati, they must be ready for this. They've seen the pro play. They've got that mate. It should be on lockdown. Undead Donut, you know, we've seen him do a great job on the DPS characters so far. And mate is a pretty easy transfer of skills when you try to pick her up.
Yep. Take a look at the Rip Mandata statue, or the icon. Or what is that? It's like a... I mean, maybe it's religious icon, but it's a portrait. There we go. But here we go. Dakota State University, they're going to push this through. The first wall is going to be really important, and it actually does have a hole.
Yeah, So it doesn't quite matter as Biggie Nose gets that first kill on to Sir Twiggle, and now Durthang getting hunted down by Undead Donut. Easy combo, freeze him, headshot him. Rinse and repeat coming out as Foo Foo gets cleaned up. Now Shromo on the point.
Ooh, Shromo, he might kill Biggie Nose. Oh my goodness! 225 damage if all of those shots collide, and then if you get that bonus damage from getting the critical headshot, you're going to kill nearly anything in one hit.
Yeah, 3 minutes, 15 seconds left for Dakota State here. They need to take point A. They are currently down 0-1 against Cincinnati. Shromo might get caught out by this hook. He has to be very careful because Biggie knows he looks really comfortable on this Roadhog. Oh, hook does miss, but it's through that Wraith form.
He's very close to his whole hog. Saber close to Soundbear as well. So University of Cincinnati, in just a couple of moments, they're going to have the ultimate advantage. Hook not going to connect, and that's actually surprising considering the shield was down. There was an opportunity for Big Nose to land it. That being said, though, it's been over a minute so far, Jamerson, and Dakota State have not gotten anything on this point.
Yeah, they look really indecisive about when they want to push in. The hook comes in, Biggie Nose taking him out. That's going to stall them even longer. Foo Foo does get the kill onto GGG. So Dakota State, if they really wanted to, they could go on the offensive here.
Rukata sitting back with his Death Blossom. Also make sure and try and keep that up. And the hook misses.
And Biggie Nose gets melted by Shromo. We do have the nano-boosted Reaper coming out. That's Rukata in the back line. Death Blossom, that's a double kill. That's a triple. Now he's on the hunt for this Winston, and that's going to be easy hunted for him. There we go. Cleans that up. It's going to be Undead Donut, actually, that picks up a double kill at the end there.
Man, the Winston frozen up there by the mate was probably an accurate representation of the frustration you would have in that position when you're frozen like that. Primal Rage, unfortunately, not enough to keep him alive. And now Dakota State, they're running out of time. They have good combination of ultimates here and go for that Beyblade strat with the Ana and the Reaper ulti. Nice hook, though, from Biggie Nose.
Yeah, Zenyatta goes down initially, but there it is. Spin to win. Shromo only gets two kills off that. That might just be enough as he hunts down his counterpart, gets the kill onto Rukata, and it looks like Dakota State might have just broken the back of Cincinnati here on the defense.
Broken the back or only got one punch, we'll really have to see. But Jamerson, I think they're going to be able to get the point. We'll see, though. Oh, man, Shromo going down is not good for the members of Dakota State University.
Yeah, immediately with that pick, Cincinnati jumped right onto the point to defend, and now the whole hawk comes out. That's going to push them all away. And now this Winston jumps in, but he's got a Rukata on his flank. Should be able to clean him up. There's another Primal Rage coming out, and he's gonna kite for as long as possible, but the hook will bring him right on back. Rukata gets that kill, and it looked good for Dakota State. It looked like they might have been able to take point A, but now the offense is crumbling.
Earthshatter gonna knock down two. The kill's coming over. GGG will be taken down by Cupholder, and there is someone actually backcapping. This University of Cincinnati knows this.
Oh, they are immediately back on there. Donut is going to stall the point for now. All the teams converging here on point A. Cup holder trying his best, but take a look at that. He gets hooked in. He's got his Primal Rage again. How does he get it so often?
They got the point, actually. Again, oh. Dakota State University with a very clever back half and then knocking everyone off meant that they get the point. 2 minutes and 30 seconds added to the clock. Jamerson, they still have life in them.
Yeah, they definitely do. Cup holder gets that kill onto Rukata, so that's going to stagger the spawns, allow this payload to push even further. Right now, Foo Foo did switch on off to that Soldier 76, and no change of composition coming out from Cincinnati, though.
Romo with his Death Blossom is probably going to be pretty pivotal for the members of Dakota State. On the other hand, though, Rukata, he has his ultimate up available, too. Just no nano boost to combo it with right now.
How do you suppose those candles are staying lit? Oh, we've got the Death Blossom coming out. Shromo gets a triple kill as I ponder on that question. And now they push forward. Rukata has a Death Blossom of his own. And he's just waiting for the timing. He drops down. He only gets one kill as he is booped away. Foo Foo cleans him up. And so, things looking good for Dakota State.
The boop from Saber keeping himself alive. That Diva ultimate actually got to go a little bit higher than he would have liked to see it. And because of this, Dakota State might actually be able to get here. But University of Cincinnati, they have a Blizzard.
Yeah, the Blizzard is actually kited away from Undead Donut. Just needs to land a right click as he's reloading. He almost gets it. There we go. He's going to clean up that Lucio right now.
I think he's alone here.
Yeah, he just might be. He's got to be careful. He doesn't have his cryostasis, but he does have the wall. But he will finally get cleaned up. Rukata is now in. Does have to be careful. Right now, as he tries to contest by himself, he does that nano boost coming out, but he is getting focused down. Cup holder on that Winston, doing a great job so far. He's in the back line. He's got so much health to work with. He can stick around for a little bit. Oh, but he gets put to sleep. Kevin, great job landing that sleep dart.
I'm really impressed by Dakota State's resiliency, though. We were almost writing them off, but they were able to cap just barely after that back cap, and they got the second point as well. So another 90 seconds on the clock. Jamerson, they might be able to end this.
Yeah, we do have that attack visor for Fufu here as Undead Donut gets hit by those Helix Rockets, is gonna go down, and now Cincinnati might have just gotten a little too confident as they are getting taken out. Biggie knows, gets the kill onto Cup Holder. Earth Center comes out, but it gets swallowed up by that shield. Now, not quite using that attack visor yet. We do see the knockoff. Kevin getting knocked off by Fufu. There we go.
Unfortunately, that tactical visor was instantly negated. Rukata trying to make something happen with the Death Boss. Dirt Thang is going to take him out. And they still have three members remaining on this point. Dakota State, they're still trying to fight this. The rest of them are coming back. And Jamerson, can they do it? 1.5 meters away, and they get it.
Wow. Great resilience, like you said, coming out from Dakota State. Things did not look good, but they went again for that back cap strategy, and it paid off dividends for them, keeping them alive in this series. They've got a minute 24 left to try and capture point A here.
And part of that initial capture was University of Cincinnati pushing so far up, so very aggressive, and it's good to be aggressive. I think aggression is a very good quality to have in a team, especially when you're as skilled as Cincinnati. But over-aggression and not keeping track of objectives is not worth that price. As a result, Dakota State University were able to get all the way to the end off of that initial cap. That being said, though, they still have a monster of a task. They are behind essentially three times the time, or University of Cincinnati, they'll have three times longer to basically end the map or get as far as they want. For Dakota State, they only have a minute and 24 seconds to get the initial point and push as far as they can. We'll see if they can do anything.
Stromo, currently sitting on that Widowmaker, did do a good job on the Hanzo, but we'll see if that pays off for them again.
Well, they started with the Widowmaker before last time, and probably thought it was a part of their success or maybe a rehearsed strategy. Remember, this is the map that they chose. This was their counter pick. So I would be, you'd probably expect that they've tried this at least before in this way. Double hit scan, two tanks, two supports, so a standard 2-2-2. We want to look at Tromo on this Widow. Can he find any early frags?
They know immediately that there is one, and as you see, the supports are going to go ahead and take cover. They do not want to get picked off here. Tromo not able to connect those shots quite yet. Does land one onto that Mei, immediately forcing her into that cryostasis, but Biggie knows. Great shots coming out from him. So with that pick, there's only a minute left. GGG takes a kill for himself, and now they push forward against the offense, and GGG finds the second one. And now they're just really staggering their death.
Unfortunately for Shromo, he was not able to find any frags. He's going to swap over to this Hanzo now, and we see this very aggressive defense from the University of Cincinnati. Standing very far up, but they're going to pull it back and just go back behind the choke point. I think that's really smart. They're going to have a lot of ultimates to work with in this next fight. And Dakota State, with only 30 seconds on the clock, need to make a play happen, but it's going to be very difficult.
Yeah, you just need a little bit more disciplined play here. Don't get overextended as the charge does come in, but Biggie Nose will easily clean that up. There's the nano boosted Reinhardt, and he jumps in. Durthing tries to get into the back line, try and stall for as long as possible, but no. That's going to be an easy cleanup from Cincinnati, and I don't think they have the time to actually get back onto this point.
Unless we see some crazy back cap, I think that's going to be it. The Graviton Surge and the wall just to stop anyone from coming through. And now Dakota State University, I mean, it's a hard task ahead of them. A 4.5 minute time for Cincinnati to cap simply the first point, and they would win this time bank and end the series 2-0.
Yeah, and we saw Cincinnati almost went up against no resistance on that first point. They got the initial picks that they needed. You know, Biggie Nose on the DPS character is doing a great job of finding those initial picks. And so Yeah, like you said, this is going to be a very difficult task for Dakota to try and hold point A. 4 minutes and 30 seconds left.
So the Cincinnati Bearcats. That's their mascot. What is a Bearcat?
I'm not sure.
Do you envision a bear? It's not a bear.
The size of a cat? Or is it a cat the size of a bear?
It's actually part of like the meerkat family, I think, and like mongoose. Not a bear or a cat.
You're just throwing lots of animals at me, and this
amalgamation
of animals in my head is just... I'm not too sure.
Bearcat Overwatch hero confirmed.
Yeah, it kind of sounds like a new...
Just kidding. Totally kidding, guys.
Sounds like a new show on Nickelodeon.
Bearcat? Yeah, I'd probably watch that.
It's a spinoff of Cat Dog. Yeah.
All right, University of Cincinnati, they got 4.5 minutes to work with. Can they execute a spin-to-win strat? Are they going to go for that nano blade? Onto Donut is sitting on the Genji.
Yeah, and he did a great job earlier with it. Right now, though, not quite connecting with the shurikens. So it looks like they're going to go ahead and approach from the marquee. They're just going to jump down instead of try to get through that choke point there. Undead Donut is going to try to find that flank, and GGG gets that first initial kill onto Twiggle. That's the tank down.
Yeah, instantly a 5v6, and Biggie Nose was making huge plays before for the University of Cincinnati, and it's going to be the same story onto this entry on King's Row. Ladies and gentlemen, I think that's going to be it. University of Cincinnati with a clean 2-0.
Yeah, University of Cincinnati, that was a great performance coming out from them. We know that each individual player, they're pretty highly skilled, and then we got to see it. Biggie Nose doing a great job on that McCree. Great flicks, you know, his hitscan looking absolutely solid.
Yeah, for you fans of Data, their average rank is essentially master level, 3,500.
Oh my goodness. I just hit 3,500.
Very, very high ranking team, and their individual play was impressive. We are going to be looking at one individual for this play of the match. It's Undead Donut on Genji, and just slashes through on the backside. The reflect gets a lot of damage. Look at his target selection too. Going for the Mercy, kill the support first, get as many resets as you can, and then find even more. Holy crap. Just the resets city as he finds 4 kills in that play of the match. And carries Cincinnati to that win.
Yeah, so that was kind of like him channeling his inner Hawksaw or Shadowburn there, you know, looking up to the pros. And, you know, right now this is the Tespa Collegiate Series, so these players, they have plenty of opportunities. And take a look at Biggie Nose right here, doing such a great job on that hitscan character, that McCree. Biggie Nose, again, coming in, 3-man Deadeye. So many stars here, they all deserve their own play of the game. Even GGG came in huge for them a number of times, along with Rukata. I mean, every single player on this team showcasing their abilities.
University of Cincinnati, definitely a team to look out for in the future weeks of the TCS and then the regional championships as well, the playoffs. Because honestly, in terms of the North, Jamerson, I know we haven't seen too many teams yet from that region, but they're really looking like a contender for the title.
Yeah, they've definitely put their name in, and you know, after this performance today, I would love to see more of this University of Cincinnati team. Right now, though, we do have actually one member of University of Cincinnati ready for an interview, and so let's go ahead and go to that Skype call. All right, so University of Cincinnati, we got Biggie Nose here. Biggie Nose, McCree, how often do you play him?
I play McCree a lot, man. He's my favorite champion. I came from League of Legends, so I liked Graves a lot, and they show a lot of similarities, so that's why I like to play him.
Fair enough. There was a specific flank you had on King's Row after the second point. First of all, congrats. That was awesome. Second of all, what was going through your mind when you made that play, and why did you make it?
So I have a unique style when I play McCree. My friends call it Assassin McCree. So I like to get behind and find the healers first and take them out because they're the most important people on the enemy team. So if they're Dawn first, then we're doing good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, that was really akin to early on play before the Zero Hero Limit got, you know, taken out when you saw the 2 McCrees, 1 Backliner, 1 Assassin. And yeah, you played that to a T. But let's talk about your team. I mean, you guys are looking like juggernauts. We saw that team average rating around 3,500. How did you accumulate so much talent onto one team?
So it's a good story. Most of us came from Counter-Strike as well, so we played Counter-Strike in League. And so the mechanics in both games apply heavily to this game. So we were all on a Counter-Strike team together, and then we decided, like, hey, Overwatch came out, so let's get a team, and they're going to make some tournaments, so let's join these tournaments.
So Biggie knows, with all this skill on your roster, I mean, it's the big question here, how far do you think your team is going to go?
As of right now, we're hoping for top four, but, you know, we want to win it all, so we're going to be competitive to get up to the top.
All right, so that was Biggie Knows from University of Cincinnati. I mean, such a great showing coming out from them, and we saw they definitely have an FPS background. Biggie Knows did a great job with that McCree, and I want to see what else he can pull out. I mean, even Undead Donut on the Genji really showing off his prowess on different characters. So
that was one of the interesting things too. Undead Donut, a player we highlighted for being the highest ranked player, we didn't actually see too much of him because the rest of the team was so good. But after wrapping that match up, we are going to be taking a look at the schedule with the last match of tonight. Earlier, we saw MIT go down to Emerson. We just finished University of Cincinnati roll over Dakota State in a 2-0. And later tonight, we're going to be having Kansas State taking on Michigan.
Yep, so Kansas State versus Michigan, another Northern Region game. Mm-hmm. So one of these teams might go on to face off against Cincinnati University. So I hope, you know, they were scouting out these matches. I mean, the VODs will be there, so you got to know what's coming ahead of you. But right now, we are going to go ahead and take a short break as we set up the next match.